Yes. Rodney Mullen wasn't even in the first game. Which kind of makes sense, really. I mean, without manuals, it wouldn't make a whole lot of sense having Rodney Mullen in the game. I mean, not saying that he can't do anything else on a skateboard, but having a guy in the game that can, that is like known for manuals, and then him not being able to do manuals doesn't really make a whole lot of sense. I don't know why, but I don't think you can actually get that airtime gap without getting rid of the helicopter first. Totally thought he was going to bail there. Right. Still don't think I can do this in one go. Get the E. Get that. Nice, missed it. No biggie. Not like I'm going to do it anyway. I don't think he's got a very high ollie stat because of, I can't seem to get like any of this money like right up here or anything. Try this again. See, he can't quite get up there, so I get this. I'll try and get this other money again, but yeah, I'm not gonna get in that turbine thing now. Yeah, I missed it. Never mind. So yeah, you should have like some sort of like special for manuals, but I don't know what. It's normally left, right, triangle or something as your manual, but I don't know what it is. I'll have to figure that out. Nice. Not bad. It's just the money now. I kind of didn't expect to do it in one go anyway, because I don't seem to be able to do that. Pretty weird though, because I can do like the furnace level in THPS3 and get all of the stat point things in like one go. So I guess they're just like kind of, this level's just a bit weird. So it's all the money you've got to get. See, in THPS3 you don't need to get any, I can't even do that now. You don't even need to pick up any money, it's just stat points, and there's only 5 of them, plus a deck. So you don't actually need to buy anything in that game, it's just all stat points in one deck on each level. So it's a lot easier. A lot easier to do it in one go, that is. Right, just get all this. And then I'll spend some cash, because I don't think he can get much height, and on Skull 2 we definitely need height, so. And nope. Spend some cash, get some speed and or ollie. Actually, they're not that bad. Alright, I'll put it in air and hang time then. Okay, put in that. I don't know, that might still be too low. I might have to do some stuff here, get some more cash, and then put some more cash into the stats. Restart. Oh, that was terrible. It wasn't too bad, but should have, his landing stats also very low, as you just saw. So he can't really do a whole lot. Hate these bells. And of course, it's a flat one against the wall, so that's a harder one to get. Right, go back. Get this roll call. Or not. I know I've gone past a bell, it's okay. Damn it. Sometimes you just, like, clear that one completely. Did I get that rail? I'll do it again, just in case. I need to get this. And of course, TC's roof gap, which is right there as well. Yeah, I already had it. Look at that. Okay, here's the problem bell. Get that. Should pretty much get it now. I've got to go back for that other bell as well. Get this one though. Get this rail. Nice, right. There it is. And I got the 6-car. I didn't even realise he'd gone into a manual there. Not really much time. I'll go and get this money over here, that's about it. That's all I can do right now. He doesn't actually have too bad of an air stat now, so I should be okay. So, tape, skate, money. I think that's it. I don't know why I keep doing like combos and stuff when I don't need to now. It's just a habit, I guess. Awkward as hell, that money. Hate it. The rest of the money in this game is okay, but... Well, it's not, but yeah. There's always a bit of cash that's like really stupidly placed, like... That one in this level, the one on the rail in above the light in the hangar, that one in New York, the one in Philadelphia, yeah, there's a load of stupid money in all of these levels, to be honest. Oh shit, oh damn it, I thought he was going to go past me then. I think he kind of did, the game's just like doing its thing now. Where it just screws you over. Right, I'll go and get this S real quick. Right. Okay, should be enough time. Maybe not to get over into the secret area now, because it's just bouncing off everything. Get the tape at least. If he can actually make it, I might need to put my stats up after all. No, he get the tape at least. But not quite over that. That's all the goals done though. So it's just the cash. Yeah, it's just the cash. I'll go into the secret area and then get that one as I come over the wall. Not as I come over the wall, but after I come over the wall. Unless you got moon physics on. Yeah, so anyway, when I finish this game with Rodney Mullen, I would expect the perfect rail balance to be unlocked with him. It makes the most sense. Because it's certainly not going to be moon. I think you get the moon physics with Tony, actually. Everybody's got a cheat. I can't get up there. Gonna have to spend some cash. I must have just got lucky on that other go. It's just speed and ollie, really. That should be okay. His real balance isn't too bad either, so the competition shouldn't be any trouble either. It's just these first, when you first start out, like, sometimes the stats are really low for those, for the speed and ollie, which you kind of need to get to some of these places. Other than that, you can pretty much go through the entire game without upgrading anything. Slow ass camera. Right, there you go. Right, you should just clear that now. Yeah, that's it. Sometimes you need to like grind onto those flagpoles, but most of the time not really. You shouldn't really need to do it. Right, no. It's just this bit of money over here, which I can do just by wall riding onto the roof. And with his upped speed and ollie, it should just be very easy to get this like that. Whoops. I paused it just as he got it, so I didn't actually know if I'd done it or not, but yeah, that's it. Right. The money in the last two levels is the only problem. Otherwise, the whole game is just easy. I forget there's money even up there, because I always do that to start out this competition. Right, one more. I did mean to go over to that other rail as well and get a bit more points, but it's okay. 100k is enough for this level. Boo! It thinks you bailed. Actually, I think it kind of does bail you when you go in there, because if you... Maybe if you like manual into there or something, he's missed that. If you manual into it, probably ends the combo. He's not even getting up there. Yeah, good. I wanted to get that. Otherwise, I would have had to come back down here again. Right, so just one more heat and one more bit of cash, which is $100 on that sign over there. Sometimes you get like an awkward jump off this building and it'll undershoot the first part of the dumpster, but it'll overshoot the it'll basically land in the middle of the two grinds, which is just unlucky really. That should be good. Right, now just get this cash without bailing too much, otherwise it will screw up there. Oh shit, you don't want that to happen. I thought you would have bailed there. That's very, very rare. I don't think I've ever like done that before. Right, there you go. So I can just end the competition now because he's pretty much done two perfect heats. So you don't need to go into a third heat to cancel, to like fix any score, so there. Right, spend some cash again. I'm just going to max out his rail balance as well. And speed. Switch as well, do that. Manual. Spin. No. But that's okay now. I shouldn't really need to spend any more throughout the entire game until maybe getting the money on the bull ring, because it's high as hell, and if you've watched any of the previous videos I've done, then you'll know how annoying that level is. I hate it. It's okay if you're doing just the competition, but if you're trying to do the cash, it's super annoying and pretty difficult. It's just they've put the money way too high up, basically. I'll give that one more try and then I'm done. Right, there you go. Save skip for another time. For another round. It's in a silly place anyway, to be honest. Okay, there you go. Alright. The skate in this level isn't even that bad. It's the tokens that the tokens are quite easy, except from the one that you need to like go off the ramp to get. It's silly. This one that I'm about to go for. See if I can get it. Nice. Alright. Good idea to actually go for the six score while going for the train tracks as well, because you get a decent amount of points going along this. Just don't get hit by the train. The train's pretty... Yeah, see, there it is. Yeah, screwed that up. Basically, the train is rarely there, but sometimes you just get unlucky like I did. So, let's try again. See, on Philadelphia, you've got the bus going around, and it's, that's actually not... That's pretty common that that bus goes around, but... On this level, they don't seem to go around that often. I really wish you could revert in this game, though. That's the only thing... That's, like, the best thing they added in THPS3, the revert. Without that, once you go up a vert in this game, that's the end of the combo, because you can't do anything to come back down and continue. That was... He wasn't supposed to jump off there, basically. But, at least I got the grind the rails crap, so yeah, that's good. I jumped over that. It's disappeared, now there it is. Don't you just hate, like, flat graphics? I'm sure they could have, like, 3D modelled that thing. Where's the other one? There it is. Sometimes I get 6 score without even, like, trying for it. Right, 50-50 this. Even if you're going at it at an angle, thankfully, the game kind of like automatically puts you into 50-50 mode like most of the time. Right, there's only one more reason to go up here, and that's for the cash over here. Get off there. Not sure if I can do this 6 score now. Yeah, that's the money I'm talking about, by the way, that one that I've just gone past. Super annoying. Right, that's the 6 score dealt with. No, it's not. Oh yeah, it is. There you go. Just about. Only the hydrants, didn't I just do that? I think I forgot about the last one. Yeah, it's just the hydrants and a few more pieces of cash. So, turn around. Go and get this one first. I've got most of the cash now anyway. This level isn't too bad. I mean, I think I had trouble with it, like... On one of the runs I had, like, a lot of trouble with it, but... You know, once you get used to it... This game ain't as short as the first one, though. First one can be done in, like, less than 20 minutes. Alright, one more. Don't need to worry about... points. Alright, so... Let's see. There's that bit of money up there, so it's actually... easier to just go up here and jump off the rails to get it. I think you can get it another way, but this is easier. Just going along here. Grind on... No, don't grind. Just jump and get it. There you go. Get this one. Oh, shit. See, that one, that's the problem one. Can normally get it going up off this one on the left, actually. And jumping over there, you'll see, like that. Right, there's two more. This one over here. Somewhere there. And then one on the fence. Which is also kind of awkward, but it's not difficult. You just gotta have a lot of speed. Problem is, this vert isn't in line with it, so you've gotta kind of go off to the right a little bit, see? See, it's not in line with it, it's like kind of over here. There you go. Alright, Venice. Venice is pretty easy. Unfortunately, in the last run, somehow I didn't manage to get the four VR transfers, even though I kind of pretty much did it, but yeah. Alright, so the points... The levels from now on that require you to get, like, a 6 score are really easy. Like, for some reason, the further you get in this game, the easier the points are to get. Despite it saying, like, 250,000 in the next level and whatnot, even though the amount is going up, it's extremely easy to get them. Like that, see? I did that in less than 30 seconds. That's what I'm talking about. So now we do the transfers, this one being the hardest one. I actually did that as well. Surprisingly, since he has a average air stat. So yeah, I did all four of these in the last one, but for some reason it said I didn't do it, even though I did. Shrug. Okay. I might have enough time to go and get the other spur cans, I'm not sure. Right, tail slide this. The Venice ledge. Which I never ever knew where that was when I was playing this like 15 years ago or whatever. Wow, this game is actually 15 years old as well, I've just realised. Cool. Year 2000 I think this came out. This game, these games came out like every year. It was a yearly franchise. Basically, this was Activision's Call of Duty before Call of Duty. But the thing is, though, these games were, like, super awesome. Like, every game offered, like, something new. Like, it wasn't just a few, like, little differences here and there. It was, like, completely... I don't know where this last can is, so that's that. Oh, yeah, I do. I just remembered. I could have got it as well. Never mind. Okay, I usually go for skate and the tape in this run. I don't know what the input for that is, he's just randomly pulling it off. Wow, I'm surprised you got that there. Right, try and get this knot here. That's another quite awkward one. There's another one up here as well doing this. I can sometimes make this, though. It's, well, yeah, I did it, but getting the money as well, quite tricky. There you go, I got it. See, all the money is on the roofs, basically. There is no letters, like, on the ground, or close to the ground. Right, get this E first, because it's over here. Because if I go for the tape, it means coming back up here again, so it's faster to do that. Right, get this cash as well, because this is quite awkward. You don't need to come up here anymore as soon as I've got this and the tape and the letters. There you go. Right, so I'll get the T and then go for the tape. If I miss the tape, I'll just restart, because it takes equal amount of time to get yourself back up here, and as well as just like restarting the level. See. Annoying. Thing is, though, if I get the tape, I can still, like, get the spray cans and the bomb in one go, so... It doesn't really matter. Right, get that looks good. Yes. Yeah, right. Right, so now we go for the bomb and the spray cans. I think we only have the 250 to get on top of that thing as well. Gotta remember where the spray cans are though. Sometimes I forget, even though I've like done this a bunch of times. Right, there's one up here. I actually forgot one last go as well, on the last run as well, but I still got it in time. Right, that one. I think I forgot the one at the other end. I'll just get this. I actually should have got this coming back over when I come back to get the last bomb. Because he appears right here. There's that 250 that I was talking about. I'll try and get that on my way back as well. Right, so this one, and then there's one like right down at the bottom, which is what I forgot. Obviously, me going for the tape in this run is, I've got like a little bit less time. So yeah, this is going to be quite tight. As well as I need to get that 250, I'll have a go. This should be enough time to get to the bomb as well. There, I've got that. And then just get the bum who is up here. Don't get stuck on the stairs. Right. Right, next competition. Again, super easy. The easiest part of these games are the competitions. Like, for any of the THPS games. As soon as you know, like, a good spot to get loads of points, you just basically use that every time. Which is this spot here for me. Although, I didn't mean to do that sloppily. I can usually land that perfect, but oh well. Right, now we go for some cash. So you've got to get this rail here, which will open this outdoor area. And there's a pretty tricky piece of cash to get. Again, this is probably this level's tricky piece of cash to get because it's so high up. And of course, this being a competition, you don't really want to bail. So you've got to get that and pretty much land. Right, get this one. If it looks like you're going to bail, you can actually just end run before he bails and then it won't do that. So, like, for example, if you get, like, a piece of cash, but you know you're going to bail, if you stop it before he does and then end the run, he won't bail. Which is handy. Right. Crap, I messed up. I kind of messed up. I should still be able to do this. Basically, when that second heat starts, you kind of want to, like, not move and, like, pivot around and get that. It's delayed me by a few seconds. I should still be able to get this level done in two heats, though. Provided I don't bail. Right, there's money up here. That's also kind of hard to get that one as well. Well, it's not hard to get. It's just, knowing whereabouts it is. Right, get this money out here, and then I'll come back and get, like, some more points. See, because I haven't bailed, I don't really need that money. Right, so let's do this. Just one more pass on this real quick. There you go. So we'll pretty much get first now. See, the only thing that holds me up in this game is the bull ring, because I can ever get the money in one shot. I mean, I restart the competition like a whole bunch of times, just getting the money. Like, it's, I can never do that in one go, because the money's just too high up. It takes me so many tries. Right, Philadelphia, my favorite level. See if I can do this quick. Not quite. You can. I got up there in the last level though. Right, so get the points real quick. This one takes a little bit longer. I'd say Venice is probably the fastest six score to get in the entire game. This isn't too slow though. It's just doing this a bunch of times. See, if he'd manual when I tell him to, it would be a whole lot quicker again. There you go. Right, now, Liberty Bells. This one. Right, I would do that whole, the blunt slide, the awning thing, but sometimes it just doesn't want to do it for me. That time, I got lucky. Right, two more Liberty Bells, and I'll go for the tape as well, because the tape's quite easy. Right, so there's one. And there's one more over here. There it is. Right, now go up this. That's not... He's not going up fast enough, so I might just be able to get the tape, but not a whole lot else. There you go. Right, that was a good run though. Despite how big this level is, you can actually do quite a bit in one go. So yeah, this is where the game starts like taking like a good few tries to get some goals, because this has like the worst place. Wait, I don't know what happened there. But yeah, this has like a really badly placed $250 note. Which you'll see. You gotta go up here. It's actually, I don't know what the fuck's going on there. It's harder to get than the tape, basically. Which doesn't make any sense to me, because the tape really should be the hardest thing to get in any level. In my opinion, this should be a $500 note. If he'll actually get on this thing, which he doesn't really want to go up there, does he? He's like totally against going up there. He's like, no, I went up there once, that's it. Right, there you go. Right, so you got to get up to this building here and get on the roof like that, which is really difficult because it's really skinny, and then you got to like land on this. So yeah, that's pretty much the hardest part of the level. Right, and then you've got to go up there again, but it's just onto the balcony, which is very easy. You can actually get on the balcony by doing the if you get enough speed, like this, you can normally get up there like that, but I don't have maximum air skill, so it's not. Probably not going to happen. But it doesn't matter anyway, because it's easy to get up there the regular way. Right, so I'll get scared now. That K is pretty difficult. Right. Okay. I already opened that secret area, so I don't need to grind up that little wire. Right, get the E. See, you've got to drain the fountain, obviously because it's a goal, but there's also money in there as well. Oof, I just made that. There you go. Right, then grind along here and get this note. Like that, and then I don't need to go up there ever again. Damn it. I'm sure that's a gap to get like from this wire here to the other one, but it's just not fast enough. I can never... There you go. Okay, so, as soon as I get this money, and there's one more up there near the, like, to my upper... That's also hard to get, by the way, that one. Yeah, as soon as I get these two pieces of cash, then it's just all in the skate park. So, hold on, I'll get this one. There's money right on the end. There it is. Getting enough air for that one is tricky as hell, even on max stats. To be honest with you, I don't really think stats make hell of a much difference at all in this game. Like, you know, even with maximum ollie and speed, like, some jumps in this game are still ridiculously difficult. Yeah, thank God for that. See, I was nowhere near that, but I don't even care because it's so hard. Right. So, we might have enough time to do the lip tricks here as well. This is quite annoying because sometimes they'll just grind it instead of, like, lipping it. Whoa, shit, that's a lot of... That was quite a big jump there. Didn't quite mean to do that. See, there you go, see? I went up it straight and he just started grinding it. And again. And again. You basically want to go up it straight, but it, like you've just seen like three times there, this is another luck based thing. Okay, that was lucky as hell. He did it in like the final second there. Still got to get the cash though. But it's all in that skate park, so it's okay. See if I can get over this. No. So after this level, I'm gonna spend some cash and get his. Well, I'll probably be able to afford everything at this point. I'll be able to max everything out. You get a lot more cash than you need to. I mean, it's you can buy like tricks and stuff. That's pretty much what they want you to do with it. But I never bother, to be honest. I just focus on the stats and the deck. That's the last bit of money there. Get that. There you go. Right, so. This last level is super annoying for getting the cash. Buy stats. These two are the main ones I want to get up, but... Like I said before, I've got enough money to pretty much... max everything out at this point. Skate shop. See, on THPS 3, you don't even have this. I mean, you've got a skate shop to, like, change your deck and stuff, but in order to get decks, you just basically find them in the levels. You don't have any money in that game. Which, I kind of prefer that system, to be honest. Okay, this one. I tend to go for the money before going for the competition, because if you do the competition, it kicks you back out to the main menu, which, you know, it's only a few seconds, but even so, I always just go for the... cash. That's not the difficult cash. The difficult cash is up here on these, like, flag things. And this is the easier one as well, because you've got this, like, half-pipey setup here. Damn, you just went past that. So, yeah. So you pretty much end up spending about 20 minutes on this level just trying to get the cash because it's in such a stupid place. He's made the same mistake again, he's going up the wrong way. Bale. Deja vu. Give it one more shot. Sometimes they'll lip it as well like that. But that's not even the hard one. The hard one is over the in the opposite corner of the stadium. And sometimes they'll do that as well, which is also very annoying. Basically, I think they just like kind of shouldn't have done this on this level. It really does ruin it, getting the cash on this level. Oh man, it was right there as well. See, isn't it weird like how in the last level you mess up the lip trick so much, but in this one, even though you're going at like an angle, he'll still just like lip it instead. So yeah, it doesn't make any sense to me. Right, there's one. That's the easy one though. The hard one is behind us. And there's absolutely no, like, these little hump things in the middle here are really in the way because they'll screw up. Oh, look, I nearly got that first time as well. See, it's very, very difficult to get up there. I nearly did a 900 as well, trying to get that up there that time. It's just stupid. I don't know what they were thinking making these this high. It's ridiculous. I mean, I'm going full speed, full start, everything. Everything's just like on maximum. Still can't get up there. So as soon as I get the moon gravity cheat, I'm going to enable it, basically. Since I've pretty much done this with about 3 or 4 characters so far as well, it's not really that bad cheating to get it for the rest of the people, because it's just a huge time sink just trying to do it with everybody, and it's like the same thing every run. You come up to this level, you get up to this, and it's just complete and utter stupidity trying to get up this thing. And then this isn't even, I mean, this is the hardest bit of cash to get in the level, I'd say. Maybe the entire game. It takes so long just to get up there. But, you know, there's the cross wires, like, at the top of the level. There you go, I've got it. There's 2 cross wires as well, and that's also pretty difficult. So the money in this level is just stupid, in my opinion. See, I'm trying to get on the cross wires now. You've got to do this twice as well, because there's 2, obviously, because the cross wires. But, yeah, I've got the hardest one now, so it's okay. The rest of it shouldn't be too bad. Sometimes you'll just overshoot it completely. I think they should have made these stands a little bit more depth, so you don't go right over like that constantly. Fuck's sake. This game pisses me off so easily. Like, seriously, I mean, simple basic input, like just jumping up there, and it's just, you know, it's just a pain in the ass. I don't even hate this level. I mean, from all this bullshit, you'd think I would absolutely detest this level, but I actually don't. I still kind of like the level. It's just the money placement lets it down a lot. Right, here we go. Nope. The hardest part is, you know when you, like, switch around? Basically, your balance inverts. So if he's leaning over to the right, then he's leaning over to the left when he turns around, and that's what makes it difficult, and I don't know why he lips it, because that doesn't make any sense at all. So, yeah. Moon gravity for the win on this level. But the problem is, if you've got moon gravity enabled, and then you try to get up into the stands, it's gonna... I mean, I'm overshooting it now, just, like, regularly. I mean, he's gonna go right up, like, over the damn thing. Shit. Gotta grind it. Yeah, you can be here for like 20 plus minutes on this level. I've already spent like, what, 6 minutes? I got up to this part like at the 40 minute mark. I've been on it 6 minutes now, just trying to get the money. Still don't have all the money. And it's funny because the competition itself takes about one and a half minutes. So, it's just stupid, like, seriously. They totally just made a mistake with this money in this level. Sure, they could have put it in other better places. And like I said, there's another wire to get onto as well, going the other way. And, you know, everybody will be saying, you know, why don't you launch yourself off this ramp? It doesn't work. I've tried it so many times, you never ever get up there. It's just stupid. It's just there to troll you, basically. And even though you don't need the money, and you're not going to spend it, you do need it for 100% to get, like, all the unlockable stuff. Right, there you go. Keep on it, keep on it, keep on it. Right, that's one done. Gotta do the other wire now. Thankfully, I'd already got that other note from the other side. Basically, there's 4 notes to get, and I've got 2 now. It's just this other one. Like, if you thought the 250 in Philadelphia was bad, and then you get up to this one, it's, you know, then you realize, oh, wait. It wasn't actually that. Ooh! Invisible! Where's Rodney gone? Rodney Mullen has disappeared. Like, no joke. Never had that happen before. Good going, Neversoft. Still a better job than Robo Mordor, whatever the. However you pronounce that studio's name. I think it's Robo Mordor. Robo Mordor. With cel-shaded graphics. Shit. Cel-shaded shit. At the very least, the game won't have anything like this. That's one thing that hopefully they don't do. Put the stat points or the money or whatever they choose to go with in stupid places. Because it's really ruined this level. Almost ruined the entire game as well. Yeah. Yep. 10 minutes now. And counting. Still don't have it all. Got most of it. Still don't have it all. Actually, I've got half of it. Because there's still more money after getting these 2 notes as well, but it's... It's easy as hell to get the rest of them. Like, literally, it is on the floor because it's in the shit, you know. It's in the bullshit. Right, get on it, keep on it. Fuck. See, his balance switched. If you can keep your balance after he's turned around, then you've got it down. But I'd hate to do this on like minimum, well not minimum, but you know, super low. Rail balance, okay, stay on it. Get this other one. Yes, right. Easy money now. So, you know John Connor's a fan of this. Since he says it like twice in that movie. Right, let's go. Right. Bright green. And then you can actually do the competition after this as well, like... Yeah, you almost forget that this is actually a competition level. You'd think that this was just like a bonus level or something, but it's not. It's just a really stupidly designed, money-wise designed level. He's coming. There we go. Alright, let's do this. I'll do this in like less than freaking, like, less than 2 minutes easily. Both rounds. Obviously both rounds, because one round goes on for like 1 minute, but you know. Can usually do it in like less than 30 seconds each time, as you can see. Getting an awesome combo. Just don't lose it. Wow. Okay, I would have expected 99.9 there. Some judges are just arseholes, aren't they? They just hate on you for no reason. Right, one more round. Whoops. Bull plant. Don't quit. You want to end the competition. Alright, there you go. Weight cheat available. I don't even know what half of these do. Anyway, yes, that's that. Chad Muska up next. Stay tuned.